talking about becoming 10 times better. Becoming 10 times better. In the book of Daniel chapter 1, 11 to 14, then we'll now go to verse 20. Daniel 1, 11 to 14, then we'll go to 20. Let's see how these guys being led by Daniel, I believe, became 10 times better. I want to be 10 times better all the time. And one thing about the scripture is the scripture has been given unto us to instruct us. Meaning that whatever you see in the scripture that God did, He can do it. That's why they call Him Jesus Christ the same way, yesterday, today, and forever. Trying to tell us through that scripture in Hebrews chapter 13:8, you see that, Hebrews 13:8, that whatever He has done before, He can do today. And you don't even need to wait till next tomorrow to find out if He will be able to do it. He will always do it again and again. Then said Daniel to Mesa, whom the prince of the Enochs has set over Daniel, Ananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, prove thy servants, I beseech thee, 10 days, and let them give us pulse to eat and water to drink. Then let our countenance be looked upon before thee, and the countenance of the children that eat of the portion of the king's meat, and as thou seest, deal with thy servants. So he consented to them in this matter and proved them 10 days. Can you just go to verse 20? And in all matters of wisdom and understanding that the king inquired of them, he found them 10 times better than all the magicians and astrologers that were in all Israel. In fact, we have in between scriptures that are even longer. We stop at 14. Can you continue from 15? Continue from 15. Let me see. Even this is even their mental capacity. Okay, 15. And at the end of 10 days, their countenances appeared fairer and fatter in flesh than all the children which did eat the portion of the king's meat. Okay, I will have said Daniel 1, 11 to 15, then 20. That would have made no sense. 10 times better. You know, yesterday when I was trying to get the ministration for today, and I set my heart to understand and know what God will have up to minister today. And God, today being the beginning of the final seven days of praise, I sought God in my heart, and God was ministering to me. He first ministered to me concerning what we talked about early this morning at early people hour. The dangerous ground to tread upon. The dangerous ground to tread upon. What did he say that was?
Being ungrateful.
That ingratitude. We're talking that he was showing me about the story of King Saul. King Saul was very favored. He was looking for asses. And God helped him to find the asses, number one, and also gave him a throne. After a while, he prophesied with the prophet without going through the school of the sons of prophets. And many other things happened to him. But the kingdom did not last in his hand. The Bible said that they rented the kingdom into two. They snatched it from him. They took it from him and gave it to somebody else. And the reason they gave it to David, when we consider the two of them, it was not that he sinned more than David. There are some sins that they did not even mention anything about woman. He didn't anything about woman or mother set of that like David. What made David to be considered better? Because Samuel was speaking in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 15 verse 28. 1 Samuel 15 28 said that God has rented the kingdom and has given to your neighbor. He didn't know who that neighbor was, but later we discovered that God was referring to David, who was in his father. And Samuel said unto him, the Lord has raised the kingdom of Israel from thee this day, and has given it to a neighbor of thine that is better than thou. I know something about David. David sinned so much too. But God considered him to be better. Just like we are talking about Daniel and his colleague, 10 times better. David was in all application, in my own consideration, one sinner. He disobeyed God too. What he did that God really penalized him was disobedient to him. But what David also did, he is under disobedient. But what makes God to just be gentle with somebody and not be gentle with another one? The sin of ingratitude with all that God did for King Saul, you will never see anywhere or read anywhere where he gave thanks to God. Never in the scripture. We were not looking for the throne, but God gave him the throne. He was not saying, make me a prophet, let me be able to prophesy. God made it, they even started having a proverb after him. Nothing that he could even say, Father, I thank you. That was a dangerous ground. And we were saying in the morning that people that are ungrateful, what they have will be taken away from them. Many people have lost many things. They used to have something. They used to be up and doing. They used to have so many possessions. But now, they are having less. Some of them have almost nothing. Why? They were not grateful. That is a law that every careful Bible student should take note. Never be ungrateful. David was never ungrateful. In the book of Psalm 18, 46 to 49, Psalm 18, 46 to 49. Unlike King Saul, every little thing that God did, he ascribed the glory to God. If you read the book of Psalms, you will see somebody praising God with all his heart. And every little, he even said that he had made up his mind that in all situations, David, the Lord liveth, and blessed be my rock, and let the God of my salvation be exalted. It is God that avenged me and subdued the people under me. He delivered me from my enemies. Yet thou lifted me up above those that rise up against me. That was what David was telling God. Thou hast delivered me from the violent man. 49. Therefore will I do what? Give thanks unto thee, O Lord, among the heathen, and do what?
Sing praises.
There are going to be the difference. The difference between, because if you look at the scripture, you might have a trying to find out what was it that this guy, did he sin that much in Saul? The major sin that he sinned, that God marked to be like 99% of sin, was just that ingratitude. They're not even told that he married many wives. But this thing ingratitude, David, with all that he did, the kingdom, even though there was a particular time that the kingdom was taken away from him, but because of this act of gratitude, he recovered it. And not that he only recovered it, in his lifetime, he saw his son being enthroned. That happened to be the highest form of success in our consideration is not to succeed, but to see the people that you have mentored succeeding in your lifetime. That's the highest form of success. Also, I actually saw this in the book of 1 Kings chapter, I think chapter 1, 1 Kings 1, 33 to 35. You will see there, in his lifetime, was he alive? He had his son on the throne. Imagine, not that when he died. Uncommon, God gave this guy David uncommon favor. Things that other kings were not able to do. He made him that. You'll be alive. Just relax and let your son be there. And they told the king, saying, behold, Nathan the prophet. And when he was come in before the king, he bowed himself before the king with his face to the ground. No, 33, I said 33. we'll see, it's still the same story that is going to go 32 to 35. The king also said unto them, take with you the servant of your Lord, and cause Solomon my son to ride upon my own mule, and bring him down to Gion. And let Zadok, the priest, and Nathan, the prophet, anoint him there king over Israel, and blow ye with the trumpet, and say, God save King Solomon. 35. Then ye shall come up after him, that he may come and sit upon my throne, for he shall be king in my stead, and I have appointed him to be ruler over Israel and over Judah. In his very lifetime, he saw his own son sitting on the throne. In the book of that same 1 Kings chapter 1, I think 47 and 48, 1 Kings 1, 47 and 48. And moreover, the king's servant came to bless our Lord King David, saying, God make the name of Solomon better than thy name, and make his throne greater than thy throne. And the king bowed himself upon the bed. What a humble man. And also thus said the king, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, which has given one to sit on my throne this day, my eyes even seeing it. David had the heart of gratitude, and he was able to live long to even see the one that he has mentored occupying the throne. So we said this morning that the sin of ingratitude makes people to fall into dangerous pits, like the elephant that we gave the story, elephant and the tortoise story that we said this morning. But we are not talking about even Daniel. Daniel was said to be 10 times better, and his other colleague, than the other people. Many people will say that it's because of the pulse and water or vegetables that they were eating. No! Let's stop reading the scripture. Let out the word. So it's deeper than that. When you interact with the Holy Spirit, it will be giving you, taking you deeper than the surface that people read. 10 times better. I'm sure when the other people saw that, they would have gone to charter a lot of water and pulse to be eating. But they discovered that they were not as wise again. Meaning that there was something about that 10 times better. Daniel was somebody that was always blessing God. Daniel was a worshiper. Even though they always talk about him praying 3 times a day in the book of Daniel chapter 6 verse 10, Bible says that once in a day, after they told them not to pray, he prayed. Now when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went into his house and his windows being opened in his chamber towards Jerusalem. He kneeled upon his knees 3 times a day and prayed and did what? And gave thanks before his God as he did aforetime. Secret of him being 10 times better. 3 times a day. He will take time off at work, maybe during his break, and go to the gents. And they say, Father, I give you all the glory. I thank you for even giving me this job. I thank you for all that you have done. I thank you for my help. 3 times a day, diligently. You have said that as he did at first time, that was what made him to be 10 times better, not what he was physically eating. But a lot of them would have just be watching him and be eating the same thing. Did they tell us that they were better? No. In fact, he got to the time that the thing was manufacturing in understanding, made the king to come and bow before him. I've never seen king coming to bow before his subject before. But when I read the book of Daniel, I saw the king. I saw that other people would come and bow before kings. But king over somebody and now coming down to bow. In the book of Daniel chapter 2, 46, you see there. Daniel 2. 46 to 48. Then the king Nebuchadnezzar fell upon me. Then I read it for the first time. I said, could this be happening? Fell upon his face and worshiped Daniel and commanded that they should offer an oblation and sweet odor unto him. The king answered unto Daniel and said, of a truth, it is that your God is a God of gods and a Lord of kings and a revealer of secrets, seeing thou couldst reveal this secret. Then the king made Daniel a great man and gave him many great gifts and made him ruler over the whole province of Babylon and chief of the governors over all the wise men of Babylon. His secret was giving thanks to God. You know, initially I was telling God that when he was taking me to this class, I said, but it was more of a prayer. I used to say that, Daniel prayed. He did very well. And I said that, okay, he gave thanks. It was somebody that was always giving thanks. When you are a thankful person, your tank of wisdom will be full. When you are a thankful person, your tank of knowledge will be full. When you are a thankful person, your tank of resources will be full. When you are a thankful person, especially a pastor, your tank of anointing will be full. Let's become thankful. Don't always talk about what God has not done. Talk about the things that he has done and give him thanks. That is how to draw his hand unto receiving more. I was telling God that, but he was just praying, praying, praying. He said that, have you ever checked the content of his prayer? In the book of Daniel chapter 2, 19 to 23. Daniel chapter 2, 19 to 23. He now took me through that portion. He said that whenever he wanted to pray, those 3 times in a day, see, he always blessed me. Then was the secret revealed unto Daniel. In a night vision, then Daniel blessed the God of heaven. Daniel answered and said, blessed be the name of God forever and ever, for wisdom and might are his. And he changed the times and the season. He removed, those are words of praising him. He removed kings and settled up kings. He gave wisdom unto the wise and knowledge to them that no understanding. He revealed the deep and secret thing. He knoweth what is in the darkness, and the light dwelleth with him. I thank thee and praise thee, O thou God of my father, who has given me wisdom and might, and has made known unto me now what we desired of thee. For thou hast now made known unto us the king's matter. God now took me. He said that this is a typical prayer. To start prayer, you first give thanks to me. That happened to be the reason for his becoming 10 times better. God told me, or the Holy Spirit told me, forget about the water, the oil, the vegetable. It's the attitude of gratitude. If you are somebody that is always grateful, there is no limit to where you can get to in God. These 7 days that is remaining, I know that many of us, we are itching to ask God so many things. When you are a worshiper of God, what you don't even deserve, God gives to you. What you will not ask him, you will not even remember to ask him, he organizes this for you. Because you are giving him something that he loves. It is not prayer. Prayer is for your own benefit now. But you are not giving him what he loves. But tomorrow morning, just like this afternoon, when I was considering what we'll be talking about tomorrow morning, was already telling me what it will be in the eyes of the groom. You know, when there's the bridegroom. How does the bridegroom behold things? When you give God what he loves, it is very easy for him to give you what you love. It does not require much wisdom, I mean, that statement. When you give God what he loves, it's easy for you to give you what you love. You too, when people give you what you love, your heart opens up to them. It's just natural. So let's in this 7 days bless him. Thank him for what you have. I know there are many things that are not okay in our life. I'm very much aware of that. But forget about those ones. When you start from what is going on in your life, at least that you can even see, you can hear, thank him. Some other part of your body may not be okay. Don't worry. See, thank him that at least you are able to do something that you are doing, that there are some other people that in that situation that they are even gone. Thank you. Maybe God start hearing that. Angel, can you see this person in the prison that is still giving thanks to me in this situation that it moves him? That is how to get. I'm telling you, other churches may be praying so much at this time towards the ending of the fast, but God has given us the key. 7 days before, 7 days at the end, and he says, see what I will do. He had even started doing before the end of the church. So things have happened in our parish, in our parish and our midst, that but I'm like, you people doing it. He did not plan it, but God will always be faithful. Whatever he has said, he will do. And I've learned to just take him by the word. I don't want to care how it happened. If he tells me, do this, I just go ahead doing it. And when I do it, the result even amazes me myself. And he has so loved these 7 days. Let's bless him. When you bless him, you become 10 times better. Not just 10 times better than your colleagues. Because if you get a time that you will be the number one among your colleagues around you, you will not know improve, but without telling me, you become 10 times better than yourself. So when you get to the point of the 10 times better, you keep on praising him, you become 10 times better than yourself. You become 10 times, after a while, the gap will even become, if you are just comparing yourself, you will not even improve too much. So that you keep on getting that which can make you to be 10 times better. It is when you give gratitude to him. Shall we rest to our feet? Shall we rest to our feet? I always desire to become better. And I know that you should desire that. I want you with all your heart to express your gratitude unto him. Forget about the murmuring and the depression that you have expressed before now. Thank you. 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 Sing your song to him. Sing your song in worship unto him. Bless him. Bless him. Thank you, Lord. Bless him. Thank you, Lord. You be God, you know, be man. again, I'm going to change that policy statement in your favor again. Thank you, Lord. Legs whenever you get home and ask the power of darkness that have been residing within your home, that have been bringing that, because you will feel it leave and it will come back again. Command those powers to get out so that I will force that command of yours and your leg will bounce back again. Thank you, God. Somebody here, you have been failing an examination. God said that the reason for that failure has been addressed now. Yeah. You will pass it next. Yeah. In flying colors. Yeah. Brother, there is somebody here, you have been having persistent headache for some days now. God said that it will be resolved. Yeah. Brother, there is somebody here, you are bothered about your child. Your child, concerning marital life of that your child, I don't know who that person is. God said that on your account, I am making a change in the marital life of that your child. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. God said that there's somebody, I'm seeing you like something. You used to be up and doing, but you're a shadow of yourself right now. People that see you now, even in the new I used to be, but they cannot even reconcile the two, even if you tell them. God said that I will help you to recover the lost years. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Just like she said somebody else, just like you saw me doing for David, in his lifetime, he saw his proteges occupying the throne of life. He said that so shall I do for you. Yeah. And receive that too. Receive that. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Not that I should tell somebody here. The enemy has planned that overnight they will gather concerning your case and determine the matter. God said that I will scatter them. Thank you, Lord. Not that there's somebody, you have been feeling tightness in your chest region. God said that the serpent that has wound itself around it is catching fire and it will be removed. Thank you, Lord. Don't ask you to sweat with our hands. I don't know what he wants to do, but I will tell us when I hear you. Doctor, there is some bloody hands amongst us. But his mercy is so strong that he won't, and that is the reason why those people have not received much. I don't know what he means by bloody hands. But God said that the blood of Jesus is flowing into this place and is going to wipe off the bloodiness in those hands.
Yeah.
And they will become pure again.
Yeah.
After which, things that they have been looking for will be rushing them.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Just apart from bloody hands, there are some accused hands here. Those hands are stolen before, or taking things, or written things that ought not to be. The same thing is happening. God's, the blood of Jesus Christ is making those hands pure, clean. Because it's clean hands in the realm of the Spirit that attract God's blessings. Thank you, Lord. It is done. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you. Give your hand unto Him. Don't give your hand unto Him. Give those clean hands unto Him now. Yes. Yes. Yeah, I can even see spark around the hands. Just like tiny sparks. Wow. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. It is done. That is what I've been preventing somebody from receiving. God has just delivered that person from blood guiltiness. Thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we are beautiful.
Amen.
I worship you.
Thank you.
If your tummy has been resolved now.
Amen.
If you your stomach or your tummy has been resolved now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
It is my nutrition. It is my enemy. If I see you to pass your day, she let me know.
I will kill the source of the itching. You better have itching in a particular part of the body, but God said that the source of that itching is killing it.
Thank you.
In the final moment, I just want you to, in your own way, just like you said, Daniel. Daniel was just telling God, He has made me to have understanding. There is no one like you. Just tell him. Shut your eyes and focus on telling him who he is. Father, who am I? Who is my father? Who is my mother that you have blessed me this much? What have I done to deserve it? Is it my past sin? My sin so much. But you have decided to forgive me. You have drawn me close. Father, there's no like you. In heaven and earth, no one compared to you. You are greater than the greatest, higher than the highest. You have blessed me so much. All things, they bow before you. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords. But we tell you this. Allah God, I am. Blessed be your name. In the Lord's mighty name, we are worshiping. She tells some people here, before 2 days' time, be getting sex for pleasant surprises. Yeah. He said, through my servant, the one that I've appointed over this mission, the prophet of this mission, I have told you that this year there will be pleasant surprises. Yeah. He said, I should tell those people that between now and 2 days' time, your pleasant surprises will be landed. Know that there's somebody here. You are not balanced on the floor. But God said that by my spirit you will be balanced. Thank you. I just want to open your mouth and just bless you.